You take all this, you put it all together, what do you have? Explain it to us.
Well, Adobe has really been on a tear, and thank you for having me on your show, David and Alex. We have two big growth initiatives. We are empowering people to create, which has been the heritage and history of the company, and we're enabling businesses to transform. The key imperative, whether you're a government, whether you're an educational institution, or whether you're an enterprise, is to engage digitally with your customers across every screen, every mobile device. And Adobe pioneered digital marketing as a category. And so what we now have is the ability for enterprises to create content, to measure the efficacy of that content, to acquire customers. And with Magento and Marketo, we extend it in two very significant ways. With Magento, we now make every experience to be shoppable and complete the last mile of actually doing the commerce part of it. And with Marketo, we extend from B2C companies, which is where the focus primarily was, to B2B companies. So it's an exciting time for Adobe.
So explain to us the market that you're going after. How do you size that market? How big is it? You've invested upwards of $6 billion in these two acquisitions to put them together. And whom are you competing with?
Well, we think the available opportunity for Adobe just in the digital experience category is well north of $60 billion. And when you think about it, whether you're a financial institution that's offering financial services directly digitally, whether you're travel and automotive, whether you're hospitality, the imperative for everybody, including in the media business, is to engage with their customers directly. And Adobe always pioneered the aspects of creating that content. And now what we think is we bring content and data together. It's a market that we pioneered, we're the clear leaders, and while there are other enterprise companies that are also looking at that same opportunity, we think we are continuing to innovate at a pace which continues to keep us distant from the competition.
Well, let's talk, you've got sort of direct competitors, or at least people who think they're direct competitors, the Shopify's of this world, but you've also got the Amazon out there, which is a pretty big gorilla. Are you concerned that Amazon really could come into this space more aggressively and be a substantial competitor to you?
Well, I think what Amazon has done very effectively is demonstrate the benefits of digital engagement with their particular customers. What we do is we enable that on behalf of every other enterprise who wants to create that engagement with their customers. We give them the tools, we give them the platform, we have a tremendous ecosystem of partners that enables them to do that. And whether you're a sports franchise, whether you're an airline, whether you're a bank, you want to create that digital presence. And so we don't view ourselves as competitive with Amazon. We view ourselves as enabling all these other enterprises to create that engagement with their customers.
So these days and age, you have to be concerned about security. Data privacy issues, you have certainly regulations over in Europe, but more generally, even yesterday, Google said that they had a problem with their system. How do you assure your customers, all those merchants, all those individuals out there, that their data is secure, that they will not be hacked?
It's a great question, and both security as well as data privacy are definitely core competencies that Adobe has invested in very heavily. On the data privacy part, we do it in two ways. As you know, we have millions of customers who have engaged with us on the Creative Cloud and the Document Cloud, and keeping that data and being transparent about how we use that data is something that is front and center for us. And on the other side, we enable all of these enterprises that are our customers to understand what are the new regulations, whether that be GDPR in Europe, and to understand how they can engage in a transparent way while keeping the data secure. So it's one of those areas that we've invested very heavily from a research and development point of view, and we have to constantly stay ahead of what's happening with regulatory environments around the world, but we were compliant with GDPR right in time for the May 25th rollout here in Europe.
So finally, Shantanu, it strikes me that there are two ways in which governments could affect your business. One is by regulation you just referred to. There may well be more regulation coming, whether in Europe or here or elsewhere. The other is by direct interference. We certainly are seeing this conflict with the United States and China right now, largely involving data. We have reports of North Korean attempting to hack. How do you deal with a situation like Chinese attempts to move into intellectual property?
Well, I think at the macro level, the first thing that we have to all remember is that digital is this tailwind and this trend where you cannot put the genie back in the bottle. And customers and citizens, billions all around the world, have the imperative to deal digitally with any business that they're dealing with. And so I think it's incumbent on companies like Adobe to help them to do that. Help the citizens to get the engaging experiences that they want, and help the enterprises to deliver that. To your point, we have to be circumspect about what the rules and regulations are, but I think good sense will prevail in all of these particular cases, because when you have boundaries that are down and you have unfettered access to markets, that's what I think will continue to drive innovation and technology in the global economy.